Welcome to part 4 of IBM Maximo Application Suite Technical Snippets brought to you by Starboard Consulting. In this video, let's go and look at an application queries and how we create those queries, edit those queries, and also how we find individual records. So over here in work order tracking, you can see on the far left-hand side, here's all the available queries that I as the user have access to. If I open up one of those, I can see my Bedford work, and I scroll over here and I see about 475 records. Well, let me come over here and apply a priority of only 3 and make sure that I've refreshed my records, which I have, and so now I have 60. So this is something important and I want to save that. Well, if you look over here, there's no action. It's interesting to be able to view and manage your queries. So what you want to do is look over here up in this middle toolbar where you have the 3 dots or the hamburger icon. And if you expand that, this is where you're able to save and manage your queries. And again, if you have access to this functionality. So I want to go ahead and save this. And this is Bedford P3. So this is priority 3 Bedford work. Oops, well, excuse my spelling, but I think you understand what I'm trying to do here. So I go ahead and I save that. And now if I navigate, yep, there he is down there. I had 60 records. So you can see that that query is available. If I come back up here in my menu and I can see the functionality to view and manage my queries, again, this is the one that I just created. It's not really that important to me, so I'm just going to go ahead and delete it, and then it's no longer available to me. Well, let me bring up another query here, work waiting for material. And now let's say that I want to take this query and I want to filter it by work type. But as you can see here, work type is not available from the list page, so I have to be able to access my advanced search. Accessing advanced search is from that same option. Some people call it advanced search, some people call it more search fields. So as you see, now here's quite a few more fields than are available on the list tab that I can have. I said I wanted to filter on work type. You know, let's just see if I have emergency maintenance. Yep, let me grab that quick. And I want to go ahead and find that. And I won't get into all the options over there, but now you can see, yep, here's my individual records that meet that criteria, which is work waiting on material with a work type of emergency. Well, let's go ahead and make sure that we have that. Sometimes people want to see the SQL syntax for that. So again, here's my work that's waiting on material in my site Bedford, and also where the work type is EM. So yep, that's a really nice query to me. And oops, hit the wrong button. No problem, we hit the wrong button all the time. Just come back to your menu. So waiting material, goodness, we said EM work. So what is this? EM work, waiting material, Bedford. And we'll go ahead and make that public if other people want to use that query. Really, really wonderful. So again, it's just getting used to where the location is of the new menu to work with your queries, save with your queries, and utilize that advanced search. Another thing that's really interesting though is imagine you come into a particular application and you know the exact record that you want to find. I know that I want to work with work order number 1001. Well, just go ahead again from that same place. See this little navigation or this little, what do they call it? A magnifying glass. Go ahead, put in your individual work order number, your individual record number, and that will immediately display. So regardless of whether you're in assets or work order tracking or PO or job plans or PMs, no matter where you are, click on the magnifying glass, put in your individual work order, and it will display for you. So that's technical snippet 4, introduction to the application queries and finding individual records. Thank you.